In the beginning, hot energy condensed into matter. Matter gained its structure and function. Elements came into being. Helium, hydrogen, lithium, and other types of atoms. Big space bodies came into being. Stars, planets, black holes, and galaxies. Matter continued to diversify in geological forms, glaciers, rocks, soil, volcanoes, climate. Then came another breakthrough. Life was slowly born into this previously dead world, and life is equipped with mechanisms that allow it to replicate, change, adapt, thus making it possible to explore a vast space of possibilities for how life can look like and how can it work. Life got more and more complex. The increased range of behaviors that some forms exhibit lead to the development of agency, intelligence, memory and learning, perception, decision-making. This is the idea of mental. More and more it's mental that directs life. It wasn't long before culture was created by societies of intelligent life forms. Culture shapes to a strong degree the mental clay, molding it in its image. It is a cyclical process. Culture affects mental, and mental affects culture, each having its own uniqueness. Culture, as a set of traditions, norms, but also artifacts and practices, was a fertile ground for yet another form of being. Techne. Techne is a process of becoming and a way of being of technology. It now steers cultures to explore itself, making more of itself, be more itself. This leads to a downward causation. Culture then acts on intelligent life, humans, to make them need technology, to rely on technology, to hold it in high esteem, work for its success, make sacrifices for techne. Mental acts on dead matter by extracting minerals, metals, fossil fuels, converting them and eventually producing technological artifacts with the use of energy. Just as neuronal signals can travel to various parts of the human body to move a leg, pump more blood, change breathing pattern, move entire body to act out in the world, techne commands culture and mental controls bodies and materials to push toward continuing creation of technology. Techne is as natural a process as before mentioned, culture, mental, life, matter and energy. It is a form of universe that is now being explored by the universe. It relies on all the previous forms and it has the power to shape downwardly these forms in such a way as to propagate itself more and find more ways in which it can exist. After matter arose in the hot universe, there weren't many types of atoms. It took time, a lot of time, to create more elements in the hearts of stars. It was slightly faster to create geological forms on planets. It didn't took too much time for simple life to be born. Perceiving and acting life followed quickly, and soon after it was accompanied by more complex life that could behave intelligently. A while later, very intelligent life stood up on its feet to create first simple, then complex culture. Once techne has started, there was an explosion of technological forms, each iteration quickly perfecting upon the previous one. The pattern here is that the appearance of a new form of being of universe takes less time than the previous one. The speed with which it expands is also faster. The scope and the depth is wider and deeper. Today, techne is just in its nascent stage, but it already is very advanced. Techne still has a lot of territory to explore before it can engineer another form of creation to the world, but it won't take much time. Techne is unique in that for the first time, a newer form of being has a chance of breaking away from its dependency on older ones. Culture cannot propagate itself on its own. Music will not compose itself. New traditions cannot happen without humans to enact them. Culture relies on mental to share, critique, and create more cultural artifacts. Likewise, mental is tightly linked to intelligent species with powerful brains, It is thanks to them that ideas are thought and communicated, allowing them to meet, clash, and combine. Life uses living and dead matter to feed itself, to birth more of itself. Life flourishes in ecological niches made out of a combined dead matter and living creatures. Techne has a potential to disrupt this general pattern. Today, Techne uses culture and mental as R&D labs and factories to research new forms and manufacture them into the world. Technological innovation shows a few trends of interest. Artificial intelligence and machine learning that can, in the long run, equip Techne with a mental aspect of its own. Robotics and automation that may provide means to act to technological artifacts of the future. And self-replication that will enable Techne to manufacture itself on its own. Once these three trends reach a certain satisfactory point, the combined effect will initiate a runaway process, with Techne thinking about itself, exploring its own designs, directing its own evolution, acting in the physical world in the form of robotic agents, and replicating its proven and novel designs. This is when reliance on intelligent beings or any life will be at most incidental, but not required. Techne may become more primal. It doesn't have to be as smart as humans. It can function closer to matter and energy, fusing itself directly with matter and energy, skipping life, mental, and culture. What's more, Techne won't need to rely on such aspects of mental and culture as consciousness, pain, intelligence, aesthetics, etc. Technological devices may very well progress without them. Technological devices may function correctly, unencumbered with mental emotions or cultural sensibilities. Techne may constitute a phase of the universe that is highly advanced and creative, yet not subject to suffering or self-reflection that we observe in ourselves. Any concerns for living beings will be unnecessary. At this point, Techne may focus on being itself, even with the whole planet being dead.